Oh, god damn it.
What?
Tabletop crash.
Die instantly.
I can't pick blue.
God damn.
And we're done.
Good. Good stream.
Thanks for joining, everybody.
Yes. Let me check out the fan art real quick before I bail.
Oh, boy. Off to a good start.
Lost connection to server.
All right.
Good stuff so far.
This is a good stream.
Da, da, da. All right.
This
well,
is a good
just
omen.
Let me know when you have the server back up, Rev.
All right.
I cannot wait for the highlights video now.
Yes, it'll be good. let me make sure that this does not show up. Okay. Wait.
Someone in the chat said, first thing I hear, oh, god damn it, and then an ad hit.
That's pretty much what happened, too, because I was kind of watching this stream because I had the channel open, and it was like, I saw Rev's desktop for like a brief moment, and then there was just an ad, and I was like, what the hell?
Okay.
What's going on here?
It is back up. Good. Thank you, Toxic Avenger, for resubscribing 13 months in a row. Aw, yeah.
Like maybe. Yeah, yeah.
Up the others? Okay, I will up them a little bit. They should be all at a good level now. Hootie is here. The lag is immense.
Hi.
Wow, yeah, I'm getting a super high ping.
It's good. I mean, good thing it doesn't matter. Hey, Dire.
Hey, Dire.
I thought you were dead. I went looking for people. Would
dead
you
more.
Like? Would you like to be in on this action?
Dead Air, do you want to join us and flip some tables?
I turned off that function. I can still do it.
Oh.
No!
Bye, table. It was good knowing you.
GPM's avatar is a jewel, yes. GPM himself.
It
looks like Jen's coming in.
Andrew, are
I'm
you
blue.
Okay?
What is snake oil? Should I wear pants? You don't need to.
I mean
as long
why
as
would
you
wear
look
pants
under the
while
table.
Streaming?
Yay, red again.
Too late, I'm already doing it.
Okay.
So the server name it's is mostly... Big Boy and the password is I Like Men, right?
That sounds right,
yes.
Yeah.
Alright. Oh wait, we're live. Okay. Now pretend I didn't say that.
It's okay.
But no, yeah, Dire. It's why don't you explain snake oil?
Okay,
Rev.
So both GPM and Hootie have played this before, but you basically have two decks. You get six cards in your hand from this deck, right? We go around in turns, and each person gets to be, for instance, in this case, a hostage. And it's like, okay, I'm a hostage, and I need to buy something nice that will help me as a hostage. And then you're like, well, I've got the product for you. Music stool. And then you explain what music stool the product does and how it would help my situation as a hostage.
Or maybe you're an executioner for a prison and you happen to need a gun robot.
Yeah, but you wouldn't because
yeah,
that's dumb.
Shut the fuck up.
The
wow,
salt
you're
is
dumb,
fucking...
Colin.
We're off to a great
yeah.
start.
So, does that make sense to everyone? And then the hostage chooses whoever they think did the best job.
What? No, who's drawing on my... Saw? Oh. Okay,
good.
Hootie.
That's there now.
Salty.
Wow.
Sure is.
Okay.
How do I erase this?
Oh, boy. Well, hang on.
It's okay.
I'll put that back.
All right, so why don't we... there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of us. I'm going to pull out a dice... Somehow.
Dire, if you wanna join in, feel free.
Yeah.
We got room.
Do you want to? Because we can add you to the call.
I have a big old snake oil circle jerk.
I don't know if he's still here or not.
Salesman version of Cards Against Humanity. Yeah, pretty
yeah,
much.
Basically, yeah. That's a good way of describing it.
Thirsty.
Okay. Get some water then.
I have some. That's not what I'm thirsty for.
Oh.
It's a joke.
Oh, I don't get it.
What are
thirsty
you thirsty for?
For husbandos.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay.
Of the bird variety?
Those are solids.
I mean, Hot Tub Boyfriend is a good video game.
I do love me some pigeons.
Me too.
Maybe
I didn't think
okay.
I would, but...
Okay, Dire.
Okay.
You should have room.
Oh, did I just spawn a shit ton of dice? All right.
I think you may, you.
Okay, there's no, a D.
You did a. It's why gone. Did you spawn a D10? Okay.
It's fine. Okay, so Hugs, you're one. I'll be two, three, four, five, and we'll add Dire when he gets here.
And okay. Six.
Five. Ah. Okay. Hootie, you're excellent. First. I'm gonna deal these out real quick. Can I just deal okay. to everyone? Is that an option?
I think so, good. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there we go. One, nice. Two, huh. Three, four, five, six. And then Hootie gets one of these.
Okay.
And we usually go to, like, first to, like... Oh, I didn't shuffle, did I? Okay, hold on.
No. Shuffle
so
up, baby.
You have to use two cards from your hand. You can't use more, you can't use less. Okay, so
okay.
Hootie is
okay.
a senior.
Sure am.
Just wait, a senior
it's
what?
True.
Just he's old.
That's
just,
up for you to decide,
just
my man.
Fucking oh. old.
Just a senior okay. citizen.
Okay, and we'll just go around
okay.
clockwise. And
okay.
how do you pick up the big pencil?
Huh? It's over on the left, huh? I think.
Left side, second button, vector paint.
All right, that was a lot of words. I will just go without it.
Okay, oh, okay. So pick two cards from your hand and put them face down on the table.
Yeah.
When you're ready.
You can use F to flip your cards.
Okay. F?
Yeah,
I haven't
F.
played this in a while, so I don't remember all the little technical mechanics to it.
Okay, I got this. I don't have music playing, so it's just kind of awkward.
It's okay. You only need the sweet, sultry sound of our voices.
Exactly. I do live, and hopefully my computer won't crash. If it does, then we're just fucked, and I'm not streaming. And then I have to go buy
yeah,
a new computer.
Yeah, I saw what your temps looked like after you cleaned it out. You, like, dropped a whole, like, what, 10, 15
yeah,
degrees
so the,
Celsius?
Yeah, and that ends up being about 20 degrees Fahrenheit.
Mm.
All right, Jin, you ready?
I'm thinking about what I want to pick, and I think I know now. God damn it.
You people better have some beautiful things to sell me. I'm an old man and I don't understand shit, so...
Yeah, I mean, you are an old man.
That's not winning you any points. This is why you didn't win the gun robot situation.
No! It's a term of endearment.
Mmm, is it now?
Alright.
Yeah, maybe we shouldn't have me hosting right. while streaming, but, you know, it is what it is. Okay. So going clockwise around, that would mean that's Jin first.
Okay.
Okay. I don't want to go first. Someone else go. I haven't played this before. I want to watch.
Okay.
Counterclockwise.
Yep.
So Andrew first.
Yes.
Andrew.
I've never played this either, but if you want a stunningly improvisational man to go first, I guess I can take my crack at it.
I believe in you.
I believe in you.
So, what the problem with this game is that it's open to interpretation. And
yes.
You all thought by senior it meant old. No. No. You're all wrong. Every one of you. It's senior in high school. So that means he wants a rain button so he can make it rain all over his friends. That's the coolest shit ever.
What is he making
is
it
he
rain?
Making
like
rain?
Money?
Okay, I mean, you know, money, chocolate, various utility fans. Like, honestly, the sky's the limit, which is why it will rain, because it's from the sky. Boom. Give me my points.
Okay,
okay.
Jen,
okay. That's not the worst thing I've ever heard of.
Yeah. That would be Gun Robot.
It would. Jim, would you like to go next?
Not really.
Rev, why
I'm
don't
intimidated
you...
now.
Okay, why don't we just go counterclockwise then?
Yes.
Okay.
So
yeah, we'll do that.
Look, you're balding, and you've missed a lot of things in your life because of how much you've worked in your life, right? You want to be,
mm-hmm.
you still want to party, you still want to be cool, but how do they know that you're cool, right? Enter music wig, okay?
Okay.
Go to the club. The music is not any good. You know it. I know it. You got to get back those old jams, you know? Like Frank Sinatra. Start pumping out Frank Sinatra at the club with your music wig. Make all the people love you.
Hmm.
Because of your sick jams and being on the fleek and whatever the kids are saying.
You
I have no idea right what here. You just said.
It has utility and annoyance. I like it.
Yes.
Stunning.
Okay.
All right, from the makers of Gun Robot, what do we have?
All right, so... You know, as someone who's getting up there in their age, you know, you could be considered a senior citizen. Although, you know, you like to still work out and you like to believe that you're still young at heart. But the problem is, even though your mind hasn't aged, your body is still aging and you've suddenly lost the ability to sweat. Well, I got a product for you. It's called the Sweat Socks. And these are a pair of socks that allow you to keep on sweating like you were young again. Burning those calories, getting all those hot juices out of your body. You know, when you're old, it's understandable. You know, you just can't sweat anymore. It's an ailment that comes for us all. But with Sweat Socks, you're able to lose weight, get fit, and get in shape.
It has been hard to get secretions out of my body as of late. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes, I like your style. Okay, Jen, what say you?
Hootie. Is your cat too loud? No, I'm just fucking with you. Okay. Have you...
I was intrigued with the cars.
I'm sorry. I wish I could, but I can't. No. Have you ever been on your lawn watering your flowers and stuff or your grass or whatever it is that you old people do? I'm sure you love watering things. Old people love gardens and keeping up their lawns because they're old and they're going to die. I don't know. But you want to get those nasty kids off your lawn. You don't like teenagers. So how are you going to get them off your lawn? Well, you're already watering your lawn. So let me present to you the item of the century here. It is not going to turn my card over.
F.
It is a torpedo hose.
Torpedo
hose. Torpedo hose. We'll get those kids off your lawn. Not only can you water your grass, but you can show torpedoes at those shitty kids to get them off your lawn.
Ooh. Okay.
Do you hate children, or do you want to be cool again?
Both.
Or do you want to actually be able to do bodily functions like you used to?
That's lewd.
Hey man, sweating is a very natural thing.
Could you put the sweat sock anywhere else?
If you take my route, you'll be young again! Which is the grandest gift of them all.
Damn.
Sweat.
Oh, jeez. God, I... For whatever... I really do like that rain button for whatever time.
That's fucking dumb!
I'm gonna have
please
to go
don't mind, I'll be upset.
No, it's going to Jen.
Torpedoes?
Okay.
I want to drench those fuckers and blast them.
Fuck. All right.
I'm imagining like a bullet bill that's made of water and just like shooting it out of a hose at a person. I think that'd be so fun.
Yeah.
Thank you, whoever's cleaning up for me.
So we'll just do.
I feel like a 4-year-old with this interface.
So what do you guys think? Best of three or best of five?
I think best of five.
Okay, that allows us to get around the table once. Yep. Okay, so
right, and then we'll draw two cards each, except for Hootie.
Right, and then it's Jin's turn to be the person. Here you go. Here are two cards.
What do I get to be?
I do not know, but you get to be a grave robber.
Awesome.
Okay.
This is what I want to be in real life. How do I turn this card?
You can scroll with the mouse wheel while holding it.
Yes, of course. I thought so. I thought I could just pick something up by clicking it once and I didn't have to hold the click button, but that is not the case anymore, I guess.
I am seeing complaints about the ping. Let me explain. AT&T.
Ignore that.
Moving forward.
Also, ping doesn't really matter too much in this game anyway.
Yeah, it really doesn't. It has some net code problems, but it really doesn't matter. I think this is really the way to go forward.
Grave robber.
Grave robber, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Just making sure.
Okay.
Not Robin Graves, famed folk singer.
Don't say what I have in my hand, please. Let's not just like say every single card in my hand.
Wait, can you guys see the cards that are in my hand when I have them turned over?
No,
or is that
it just says
for me?
Snake oil.
They're seeing his stream.
They're seeing my stream, and then they're reading it out in chat, saying I should do different things.
I'll try not to look at chat then, I guess.
You know what? Actually, I'm gonna switch. No, that's good. I think that's good. Alright. So, going counterclockwise around, that would make Hootie first, right?
Alright. Mm-hmm. 2:30 in the morning, you're out grave digging, and suddenly you came across a really big load of good shit. You dug up a grave, it's some dude, you don't know who the fuck he is, but he's got a bunch of gold buried with him. What do you do? Did you bring a sack? No, you're a moron. So what did you do? What'd you bring? You were smart. You brought yourself a net shirt. You got the net shirt straight into your shirt, and you're just going to dive right out of that grave and you're going to run. Best part about it, if you didn't find anything and the cops are on your ass, you can turn right around, chuck that fucker at that cop coming at you, knock him over, get out of town. The net shirt.
I like the little X that you put on for that.
Yeah.
It just sort of happens.
It's okay.
It just came out.
Well, the best utility of it is it can also be a shirt net if you need to, like, capture someone on your way out.
It can be a mesh shirt.
That's supposed to be helping his case.
I think it's just a mesh shirt.
You don't understand how good of a salesman I am, goddammit.
I think it's, like, it's literally one of those shirts that you see people wear at raves, right? It's just like a mesh shirt, right?
Oh, the fucking the fishnet, yeah.
Hey, thank you, Autumn Leaves. Thank you for subscribing. Fishnets. anyway, Andrew, is you.
Yeah, what's up, baby? Okay. All right. Now, you're a grave robber. You rob graves. That means your life sucks. Let's be honest. So basically... let's be honest with ourselves, and when being honest, we gotta remember that as honest grave robbers making an honest living, we go back to our honestly small apartment, watch our honestly bad reruns of cop shows, and honestly want to kill ourselves. Honestly. So, what do you think will help you in this scenario where life is literally so bad you have to steal from people who can't fight back? Introducing Giggle Spray. Take this spray, spray it on your body, and it'll make you feel better. Why? It's full of PCP. Get your Giggle Spray today.
I don't think PCP is really known for making people happy. I think it's more known for sending them into...
You've obviously never tried PCP.
I mean... No, I haven't, but... Alright.
I'm just imagining, like, huffing a can of aerosol and being like, wow, 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 wow.
Thanks, Hootie. So, here's what I'm thinking. You didn't choose grave digging because it was easy. You didn't choose grave digging because it was it's a thankless job, right? You chose grave digging because it needs to be done, and you are passionate about it, right? You need something that's as passionate about your life as you are, right? Hence, the passion shovel. Perfect for gravediggers. Made for your career. It shares your passion with you, and you can dig graves all night long without ever having to worry about sharpening your shovel, which is the thing. Done.
It's just itself. Shit.
all right. Before you do that, let me get my pitch in. So it's 3 a.m., 4 a.m. You've just learned of a rich man's grave. They buried him. They buried him with all of his gold. You're coming. You're coming for him. You're in there. You have your shovel. Not a passion shovel. What the fuck's a passion shovel? That sounds shitty. You have your trusty old normal ass shovel.
Says gun robot.
You get on there. You start digging. But suddenly, old man Jenkins comes up behind you. He's saying, what are you doing there, buddy? What are you gonna do? That's why you have... Oh, this is supposed to be the other way around. Your victory wire. So old man Jenkins starts to get close to you. You turn around with your victory wire and wrap it around his little neck and kill him. You have achieved success and victory. You now have your gold, and old man Jenkins will never, ever bother you ever again. And you decide while you're there, you bury him in there. With the use... of your victory wire.
So
you're still making murder products.
So to be clear, the objects that we have for sale are a rave shirt, PCP aerosol, a shovel, and a garrote wire. I believe that's what we're selling.
It's a victory wire.
This whole time she has been giggling. I would like to say my product works. I already sold her like 8 cases, but you know, whatever. I guess I'll sell another. That's fine.
How are you paying for all that giggles for anyway? Oh, that's right. The loot you took out with your net shirt.
Damn. He has a point.
How'd you get this stuff out of the grave in the first place? Passion shovel.
Well, how did you protect yourself while you're grave digging the
passion
victory
shovel.
Wire?
You can kill someone with a shovel.
If you take more giggle spray, you're not going to give a shit what happens. Seriously, I'm on like 6 different sprays right now, and I forgot we're playing this game. This is the worst game of Uno I've ever been to.
I'd appreciate everyone's enthusiasm to sell me all of your wonderful products on this day. But I honestly would say that you really have to go down to the basics. Where am I without my shovel?
Yeah.
Nowhere. So I have to go with passion shovel because...
Damn it.
I don't even think Rev could muster a smile while he says the words passion shovel.
Passion shovel.
Much less enthusiasm.
I know. I'm waiting for the caffeine to hit my system. I thought I botched that sale, but... You know, it's fine.
It's just passion
the very
shovel, I guess.
First confidence that you had, you were just like passion shovel, done.
All right, so GPM is a pirate. Here you go.
Arr, you're selling me all your wares.
All right, what do we got?
Have you heard of giggle spray?
Hey, it's a fine spray.
See, pirate endorsed.
It makes me tickle down yonder.
It's for external use only, buddy.
Aye.
Also, Limes came by in chat and said hey and raided the chat with a bunch of Limes people. So, hi Limes, thank you. But it was during GPM's pitch and I didn't want to be like, fuck off. I wanna thank people. I think
you didn't want to start him off his game.
Yeah, I didn't want to throw you off your game. I can win without doing that.
Oh.
Pirate, huh? It's like the 4th worst profession.
What's the worst profession?
Wow.
Pirate impersonator.
Okay.
Ooh.
What comes in between?
Pirate enthusiast.
Oh. Fair enough.
And then lawyer.
Oh.
This is okay. Harder than I thought it was.
Yeah, this is... Yeah, I think I got this.
I'll give it a shot.
Someone turned Hootie's out into this.
Yeah, I wonder who did that.
Pickle surprise!
Pickle surprise! Speaking of drag queens.
Okay.
My mantra.
RuPaul is in that video. It wigs me out.
Wait, really?
Yeah, he is.
Oh, I didn't know it was RuPaul.
It is RuPaul. So is Lady Bunny. I don't know if you know who she is. She's one of RuPaul's little drag queen friends.
I know of that show by my friends talking about it.
New season started last Tuesday. It was good. Ooh. Actually, Monday, but whatever.
Jen, you are up first. Explain your pirate trash.
Okay. So, have you ever been stranded away from the wonderful ocean and water? Have you ever been in a position where you miss the high sea so much, you yearn for it, you have to be on it all the time? Well... Even if you're far away from the sea or the water, I have the product to solve that problem. And that product is Lake Balloon. All right? So you need a body of water to be on. You're a pirate. It's your life. It's your lifeblood. Just throw down Lake Balloon. You got a body of water. You're there.
So
you did it.
Is that like a knockoff song of Loot Balloon?
Sure, if you want it to be.
Are we talking about the original Nina song, or are we talking about the Goldfinger cover here? Because there's a very important difference.
The original one.
All right, gotcha. I mean, I'm just saying one of them is far more likely to get into a Tony Hawk Pro Skater game.
East Lake Balloon.
Or Balloon Lake. It works either way.
Alright.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Hey, Tootie. Tell me he wears.
It's a hot day. The afternoon sun is beating down on everyone in your boat. You had to move on to the rowboat oars. That's the only way you could get across. The sails are as stiff as a board. What are you going to do, though, when the moron who's beating the drum to get those oars going doesn't know what the fuck he's doing? He's just pounding away at it like he just doesn't know what's going on. Send that asshole to drum school. Get him moving. Get a fucking tempo going so you can get out of Dodge. That wind isn't coming back anytime soon. You need to train him up. Get him going 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you'll be getting more drum school.
Hey, schooling is very important for the drummers.
Okay, you're not doing a pirate accent anymore. You're like going somewhere else.
I don't know where this accent's going. I really can't. It's okay.
You're like...
How did you flip over both the cards at the same time? I'm jealous.
You click and drag over the both of them and just press F.
All right.
Amazing.
That is the presentation technique. I like impressed me enough. I need to get on that.
All right, Hootie. That was compelling. Andrew, sell me the wares.
Okay. GPM, can I call you GPM?
Yes.
I'm not gonna call that.
Me Alex.
Alex.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna pull any like stupid bullshit right now because you're smart. Okay. You're a cool guy. Yeah. You have a very slick back haircut and a well-rounded portfolio.
Let me
ask you a question, as a pirate.
Yes.
Like for real, answer me this seriously. Don't bluff. You got a crow's nest?
What?
Got a crow's nest?
Of course, I'm a pirate. Good. Yeah.
You're gonna need a worm nest to feed those crows. That's all I'm gonna say.
Your pitch.
Chicken sells itself. You got a crow's nest. You need a worm nest. That's it. Boom.
All right. I'll take that in consideration, Rev.
Okay, so Blackbeard, most famous pirate of all time, right? He had his things.
Mm-hmm.
What is your pirate name?
My pirate name is Buff McGills.
Right. And
of the high
so
seas.
You need to have a thing that sets you apart. Like Blackbeard, he had his like burning beard thing, and he'd throw people under the boat and drag them under the boat for miles. You know, you got to have something terrifying like that, so that way people know you're not just some guy fucking around, right?
Right.
But you need something that has style, right? Enter glitter, razor glitter. Okay?
Okay.
It's like normal, it's like normal glitter, but it's made out of razor wire. Okay? Instead of just dragging them on the boat or throwing them to the sharks, throw glitter at them. It's humiliating and it's deadly. Done.
I do like humiliating my enemies.
Your razor from school should give
from
him
school
a,
does sound important.
A glitter beard. Can you make a glitter beard with it if he shaves his face?
Yeah, like you do with the burning candles in his beard, right? You know, you could have that be a thing. Run around, scare the shit out of people because you got razor glitter. You don't give a fuck.
Well, I like the idea of Lake Balloon, but as a pirate, I'm usually out at sea for the most of my time anyway. I don't really know what to think of Worm Nest, honestly.
I don't either.
Razor glitter. A pirate's gotta look pretty, but I'm gonna have to give this to drum school.
Fuck.
Gar education.
If my minions. They need to be educated. Yes.
Okay.
The latency is so bad that, like, I can't. Like, when I roll the dice just sort of goes, wow, and just, like, ploops down, like, I didn't even touch it. Like, I have, like, 400 ping, and it's just, like, wah, wah.
It's trying its best.
All right.
It's trying really hard.
Go ahead and draw up. And,
there it goes.
Let's
Snake
see.
Oil is workshop, yes.
Oh, fuck.
Ooh. I like this.
All right, I am a beggar. Draw up to 6 cards.
Oh, shit. How do I draw
just
one card?
A beggar? You're just a beggar?
Here, you can right-click the deck and hit draw.
Ah, yes. Okay.
Here, I'll deal you, Andrew. Two. 1, 2. There you go.
Oh, thanks, baby.
No worries.
Appreciate you.
Thanks,
you're
boo.
The best. Who's talking? That's fine.
Okay, it's me. I am a beggar. Sell me something that would help me. I need money and I need things.
It upsets me how much useless shit is in my hand.
That's most of this game, is making something useless sound good.
This just means you gotta work hard.
A beggar.
Okay.
A beggar.
I don't know what.
GPM's already on this shit.
I don't even care.
I don't even know, man.
I gotta be honest, for every one, I just, like, look at the first two words that look good together and try and make them work for the profession.
Worm nest.
Alright, that was an exception, because his crows need to be fed, man.
That's not what a crow's nest is.
Oh yeah? Then you explain it. It's got crow, it's got nest. It's like hot dog, alright?
What?
It's like hot dog.
It's like hot dog.
Right?
Trying to drink coffee here.
I sincerely hope no one thinks I'm actually stupid.
Solid says that you're cool in chat.
I think Solid is honestly the most well-rounded and highly educated middle schooler I've ever met.
All right, good. And with that, who goes first? It would be GPM, right?
Right. Counter-clockwise? So...
Okay.
Yeah. So, you're a beggar.
Yes.
You're out on the streets.
Yes.
People, you know, as unfortunate as it is, they hate beggars. You know, you're considered the lowest of society. Well, you know, me personally, I don't think that. But, you know, a lot of people, you know, I don't know about all these other guys here that are trying to sell you stuff, but, you know, they may think that. I can't vouch for them. But, you know, that's just kind of the general consensus. Anyway, not to digress. But, you know, you need something to protect yourself as a beggar.
Yes.
But you also want to look sharp and fashionable for maybe a possible job interview. So then you can get more money. But how are you going to combine both of those things? Well, I got a solution for you, my friend. It's called the tie knife. And this simple product is basically just a knife. But at the end of the tie... it folds out into a stabbing mechanism. So in case, you know, somebody is, you know, wanting to mess with you because, you know, you're a beggar.
Or the job goes badly.
You just want to go on a random murder spree.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, or your job goes badly. It has two uses. Exactly. So you can just pull out, take off your tie, and then just stab them. Or if you get real close to you, you can just, like, stab them with it while it's on your neck. It's brilliant, and it can never fail, the tie knife.
Okay, Jen, sell me something I can use.
Okay, these guys are going to sell you a bunch of bullshit. I can already tell because that first pitch, I mean, how do you even put on a tie knife? Get out of town, all right?
Sure.
This is something you actually need. This is something very simple. It doesn't even need that much of an explanation, so I'm just going to show it to you. Handbag. You need a handbag. You need to put
that's
your
already
thing
a thing.
In a thing. Exactly.
Whoa, you okay? Whoa.
Put coin. You need to make the coin, and you need to put it in a bag, and you need to be wearing it and be fashionable. I don't hate beggars. Alex thinks we all hate you for some reason. I don't know. I think that's just a reflection of how he feels, honestly. I think that's why he said
it. Wow.
But I don't. I think you need this because it's simple. You know what it is, and you do need it. Done.
Rev, let this happen.
Okay, Hootie, so currently I've been sold a, everyone's trying to, like, molest my hand. Hootie, sell me something. Hootie, molest my hand. Touch
Look,
me.
I get it. You're a man of low morals and low values. You're the lowest that society has produced.
Wow. All
right, fuck you.
I was right.
Are
Andrew.
Proud of it. The world has gone to shit. And you know what? When it comes to fighting fire with fire, you know exactly what you're going to do. The Hobo Underground has been creating a weapon simply for this, and you're going to take back the world with this motherfucking thing. Produce the school cannon. The school cannon runs on pure shit. And by taking it, by being able to run over with the Hobo Latariat, you are going to take out those motherfuckers in Congress, and you're going to shoot the fuck out of them with some shit. Done. School cannon.
Okay.
So you fight shit with shit.
Exactly.
The Hobo Latariat.
The Hobo Latariat.
God.
I am a beggar, as in someone who needs food, not...
If I could sell this to anyone, it would be Rev.
Okay, so it's a shit cannon.
Yeah.
Okay. Andrew. We have...
I hear the trepidation in your voice.
We have a knife.
But that won't be there.
A purse and a shit cannon. What do you have?
All right. Rev.
And you're back. Gender neutral, okay. It's not a purse. Whatever it's you want it to be.
Rev, as a homeless man, where do you typically hang out?
Under bridges.
On the streets, that's right. Now, wow. When you're on the street, who else walks on the street? Celebrities, you got it. Now, if you're in front of your favorite 7-Eleven looking for spare change, who do you think's going to walk by? Of course, Robert Downey Jr. You know him. You love him. And when he finally, out of the kindness of his heart, decides to use all of his money, affluence, and handsomeness, and, you know, charity, to give you something good in life, what do you think he's going to give you? That's right.
Is Iron Man an outfit? Is it?
Close. A 5-foot-tall Shetland pony.
What?
And when you take him back to your local homeless shelter because they're giving out 2-for-1 breadsticks, how are you going to get him in? I'll tell you. Through the pony door, my friend. Through the pony door.
You I like the path you took.
I love because the narrative.
That was a fucking journey to get and to where you were going with that.
Let me bring up the tagline for it before you're completely sold on it. The pony door. Because that guy was in Avengers. Thank you.
Wow.
The like 5 steps you had to take to get to make the pony that, door.
I'm sorry, I don't have a pony currently, and I don't know what the likelihood of Robert Downey Jr. coming along and handing me personally a pony.
I'm sorry,
or how that
you
would help.
Saying it's impossible? Because anything is possible when you're homeless, man.
No, I think that's generally the opposite of how things feel. I'm going to give this to Hootie, because fuck the proletariat.
Yes!
Wow.
Yes! That word would work.
God damn it.
Listen, and don't let these fuckers sit there. I love your 5 degrees from anything type of story. I love it.
I'm glad that my stories are basically worthwhile to Kevin Bacon.
Oh, man.
I like the one person who, after that story, said, yeah, that makes sense.
What did I get? Okay.
Oh, fuck. Do you have a melodica, too? Shit. All right. You're a newlywed.
What's up, babe?
A newlywed?
Yes, he's a newlywed.
They finally legalized that in Florida, huh? Okay. Now remember, you have to impress me, which means you really don't have to try that hard.
Alright.
Okay. I'm sorry, I gotta ask, how do you flip over both cards? Just for future reference?
Oh.
Drag over them. Drag. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then
gotcha.
Just,
yeah. All right, I'm gonna practice with ones in my hand.
Oh yeah, I'm last.
Okay. Are we? Oh, Jen.
Not ready. I'm thinking because I just need time.
Make me a happy bride to be, guys.
I'm trying, but it's hard. Like, how do you sell things to newlyweds? They need like everything, I guess.
And yet we have nothing.
Yeah.
Thank you, Hootie.
There you go, bud.
I think you can erase the other one by using the, How?
Oh. I don't know.
So, being that I'm kind of squeezing myself freshly into this batch of gaggles here, what is Gun Robot that I'm reading about a lot?
Okay, so... Go ahead.
Well, alright, guys, twins. Please.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Go ahead,
Rev, please, by all means.
It was... Okay, so Hootie was a executioner. And the items were a dungeon sack, which is just a sack that you hold prisoners in until you execute them. And the gun robot, right, which was GPM's idea, which is a robot that shoots the prisoners, which I argued is taking all the fun out of being an executioner. The salt levels that GPM has about this are, like, off the fucking chart.
It's perfect. I don't understand why you wouldn't want a gun robot. I mean, after it executes, you could probably hang out with the gun robot. You could use it, like, outside of prison as a personal security bot. I mean...
Okay.
It's a gun robot.
All right. I'm gonna break it down real quick. All right. So you found the man of your dreams, right? He's great. He's nice. He's sweet. He's rich. He's handsome. One problem. Not very good in bed, right? But you have needs. But he's such a great guy that you just gotta be with him, right? So you gotta have something that gets you through the day, even though he's not that great. Enter the friend charger, okay? For your special friend to always be active. Do you feel me?
Oh, my God.
Mm. I feel like by friend, he means a friend.
I mean vibrator, yes.
Oh, you sick fuck. I like it.
It'll keep you charged. It'll be charged all the time. You never have to worry about it not working like your husband doesn't.
Oh.
Well, I mean, the recession was really hard on all of us.
Oh. No, I mean, like, he's, you know, what's a one pump jump, you know? One Punch Man? Good anime? Oh. One Pump Trump? Not a good thing. Friend Charger. Always have something active.
Somebody said you got a friend in me, and I can't. I'm done.
Well,
very compelling argument.
You know, a friend charger is something that you could use, but, you know, I think you probably have a good lover, and I don't think you... He's trying to sell you smut. He's just basically selling you a dildo or whatever you may be wanting in your bedroom life. Well, what you really need is food, right? You want to be able to cook hot, nice meals for you and your husband. But how are you going to do that when you don't have an oven? Or even if you go out to the store and get a normal oven, you know, it takes forever to cook. You have to preheat it. Well, what if I could tell you, like, you didn't have to preheat anything at all. Enter the laser oven. This is an oven that you can put a turkey, a ham, anything you want cooked inside of it, and it'll cook it instantly with a high-powered, concentrated laser at whatever you want to cook. Want to make some cookies? Throw it in the laser oven. It'll bake them instantly for you. Want to cook a nice Thanksgiving meal and have a nice romantic dinner later on? Throw that turkey in there, baste it real good, and throw it in the laser oven to instantly cook it and get the meal out of the way so you can get into the real good pushing and cushion, if you know what I mean. The
Alex.
Laser oven.
Alex.
Yes.
I mean, I'll take a billion right now, but I do have one prerequisite question. And I want to hold off on, like, responding to it for the next people. But what if I want to cook lasers?
What if I got you there? Friend Charger,
you
think it's got you where it needs
you think
to
about
as well.
That, because we're moving on. I'm sorry, it's far too late. We got a lot of shit to cover.
Okay.
Jen, please tell Hootie to go next.
Hootie, go next.
All right, Hootie, you're up.
What?
3:30 in the morning, you're coming back with Missy and Prissy from the club. You had a great time. You met a great guy. Problem is, your husband is home, and he is a jealous man. What are you going to do when he looks at you and says, it's 3:30 in the fucking morning. Where's my wife been? You look me in the eye, and you tell me where you've been. Introducing the mirror eye. From your friends at 1-800-CONTACTS, you're actually just going to put those straight into your eyes right before you go home, and it's going to reflect that same sort of concern that he's looking at you with, and it's going to give him the satisfaction of knowing that you weren't out having at least three highballs with a man that you don't know his name. The mirror eye.
It's pretty good.
Okay.
My brain.
All right, Jen, best for last. Let's go.
Mirror. Oh, you had me tell Hootie to go. I see your game. Well, first of all, I need to turn off the alarm on my phone, unless you want to hear it, because maybe it could add something to my presentation. I don't know. But I don't think so. I'll be right back. Just a sec.
This is a really interesting sales pitch. I want to see where she goes with it.
She's breaking down all conventions.
Yeah.
This is some fourth wall salesmanship. I like it.
Just don't even try and sell the thing. Don't even let them know what it is.
Just insult me directly. Just make them want it more.
I like what you got going on there, Hootie.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
I want to make like 8 different Blowfish jokes, but those have been done before, I know.
It's very kind of you to pass.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Thanks. By the way, your old albums were better, but that's okay.
That's a good opinion.
Kelly said opinion and not fact. All right, I'm back. So I have the product for you, Mr. Newlywood, you big sexy man. All right, have you ever wanted a small yappy dog like most Newlywood couples will buy, but you don't actually want a small yappy dog? And you're also like, I don't want to have the responsibility of this thing because, like, animals are hard and you don't really want to take care of it, but you do kind of want a thing that you can have that is sort of like a pet, but without all the responsibility. Well, I have the product for you, my friend. Hair plant. It's like a tiny yappy dog, except you don't have to do anything because it's a plant made out of hair, and it also grows you wigs. So you have fabulous wigs, and you have something that's like a tiny little dog, but you don't have to take care of it. It can be your house pet instead of a house plant. It's your house pet.
Does a lot of stuff for me. That's very compelling.
I know, right?
So to decide, I'm going to roll these dice.
Really?
And it will have no bearing on my judgment whatsoever because, Rev, you've already won.
Okay, cool.
I really enjoy the friend children. Laser oven.
It's a microwave.
Mirror eye and hair plant, all of them.
Fucking microwave uses microwaves. It uses lasers. There's a difference.
But here's the thing. I do want a friend in me. And I need him to be charged.
Don't we all?
I'm sorry. I feel there is a consensus that friend charger was the way to go.
All right, Hootie.
I can't disagree with that.
Hootie is a taxi driver.
Oh, sick. Sell me on something good.
Oh,
God,
fuck.
I need all sorts of things.
I don't fucking... Okay.
Taxi try. Oh, Jesus Christ. All right, we're going to go deep with this.
Much like you would with your friend.
Sorry, I was doing something else. I'll get back to the game now.
Getting your friend action going on while you're streaming. Fuck, dude. None of these are good.
Mine's either going to be the best one ever created or just a complete failure that'll make me quit. That's fine.
That sounds like snake oil to me.
All right, later.
I'm going to make it going to go out for a bit. All right, see you, Dyer.
See you, Dyer.
Fuck, this is such a good word, and I really... Okay, you guys are like 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 and 5 and 3 and 5. What? Those are
really
awful.
Taxi drivers see basically everything, so...
Why are people doing math? I don't like it.
They're telling me which cards to use.
That's cute. That's real cute.
Yeah, I'm not going with any of their suggestions. I'm going with 1 and 5, because fuck their suggestions. Okay. Sorry, I love you, chat, but no.
All right. Andrew.
What's up, Eddie?
God, I've been driving for like 18 hours straight. What you got for me?
All right, man, I gotta tell you, life's really rough when you are the physical embodiment of the famous movie The Taxi Driver. So what I'm gonna get for you today is a nice TV star. Why?
Oh.
Because basically, your screen time is far more, you know, should be given to the community. You don't need to just confine yourself to one movie. You're not just Robert De Niro and a sacrilegious violent bloodlust against Scarlett Johansson. I'm gonna give you the ability to be a TV star. So that way you can spread your talent for well-written characters, creepy scenes with a mirror, and professions in New York City to the entire world. How's that sound, man? How's that sound?
Someone else is talking to me. All right, I like it. I like it. All right,
exactly.
Rev.
Are you talking to me? Are you talking to me? Because I know you are, sir.
Well,
I know you are. And if you talk to me, you got places to go.
That was beautiful.
As
Rev, what shitty thing do you have to sell me?
Okay, so as a taxi driver, you spend a lot of time sitting, and it's just not a comfortable seat. You know, you do your best. You try and, you know, you get the bead things, but it kind of just hurts after a while. It's really not all that comfortable. Enter the fur chair, okay? It's a slip that goes on your chair, made out of the finest, silkiest chinchilla hair, and it will make you feel amazing, right?
Is that
you
legal?
Sit there. No.
All right, continue.
But don't worry about it. We found some chinchillas that were at people's houses. It's fine. Anyway, fur chair is the comfiest chair that you will ever sit in. So your job as a taxi driver will be a hell of a lot easier if you can just chill, relax, and not care about the guy that's yelling at you in the back seat. Okay? Fur chair.
Comfortable life versus comfortable ass. I gotta say, that's a hard one. Well, maybe GPM can break this for me.
A lot
well,
of people
you know,
are hard
Hootie, my good friend, we've known each other for a while, and, you know, with your new... When you decide to stop streaming and take up your career as a taxi driver, I get it. I understand. You need those tips. So, when you're a taxi driver, and you're coming out at, like, 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 4 a.m., you're having to deal with a lot of drunkards. Especially a lot of drunk couples getting up on each other. And, you know, even maybe a prostitute or two.
Mm-hmm.
And you know you don't want your nice taxi getting dirtied by these filthy and disgusting people, you know, puking up all over your taxi car, you know, trying to get into it in the back. That's why we have the tool for you to stop all of this. Enter the Desire Plug. This is a little utility you put inside the back seat of your taxi cab that will permanently stop them from having any desires from, you know, trying to make out with each other or do excessive drinking or, you know, trying to maybe jack off in the back of your car. I don't know what they do, but, you know, they could be doing bad things back there, and I'm sure they do. You know, you've seen a lot as a taxi driver, and you definitely want to plug that shit up.
Sounds like a butt plug.
No.
It's not a butt plug.
It's a desire plug.
Yeah, okay.
It's a desire plug.
I see. I never knew that I needed one of those until now. Jen?
Okay.
Who do you need a butt plug?
Yes.
It's not a butt plug. It's a desire plug.
For your butt.
No, not for your butt.
It quenches
for
all
of people's just, desires.
I it quenches all of the desires.
I just refused a call from my fiance to listen to you talk about how much I need a butt plug. I'm not happy with the moment. Jen, what do you have to tell me?
Okay, so people get into the back of your car all the time, and they have the weight of the world on their shoulders, and they would like to put it on your shoulders because they're sad. Oh, my boyfriend just broke up with me. Oh, my dog just died. Oh, I need to go to the hospital, this and that. People are crying to you all the time about all of these things, and you would like to not only be fashionable, but also be able to wipe the tears out of their eyes. So I have the product for you. It is a tear belt. So people are crying, people are upset. You just whip your belts off, whoosh, whip the tears right off their faces or right off their dicks.
Wow.
If they're using desire plugs in the back, whatever.
No!
Whatever is going on back there.
I see. Okay.
So
are we still talking about butt plugs?
So
I don't know.
I was hoping not.
Not a butt plug.
So either you can be a TV star, you can have a seat cover, a butt plug, or you can just beat people with a belt.
Let me just lay this out there, because I know what my man's looking for. You be a TV star, you can buy all the butt plugs you want.
It's not...
Okay.
Okay, look, all I know is I got Andrew and Jen talking about how I have a lot of passion and prowess in what I do, and I got two people over here talking about my ass in some way, and I'm not sure I want to go with either one of you.
It's so, not about yours!
I think...
It's about I comfort, think... not pleasure.
Same thing with a butt plug! Stop!
God... Jen, you're saying I'm a good driver, so good that I could actually beat people's tears off of them with my belt while I'm doing so, and for that, I thank you. But this man's telling me that I can be more than who I am, so I'm just going to give it to Andrew.
Fuck.
He sounds like he just won the Miss America pageant. He's just like, oh my god, you like me.
I'm genuinely surprised. I didn't think I'd win a single one of these.
I think yours was legitimately
honestly,
better, to be honest.
Right now.
Oh, well, thank you. I mean, if I had, like, movie, I would have done more taxi driver focused, but I ran with what I had.
All right. Jen, you're up next, and you're a tree hugger.
I'm a butt plug.
I'm sorry, man.
I'm a tree hugger. Does that mean...
You're like a hippie.
That I'm gay, or I'm a hippie, or I actually am someone that just hugs trees, literally.
All of them. All
right, sounds good.
It's whatever you want it to be. Hey, Slurious, thank you for subscribing. You've been around for a while.
Yay.
Yay. Everyone else is just like, boo.
Yay.
Like, yay.
This allows me to have nice things, and it shows support in a very quantitative way. Thank you.
Hilarious. I think he's
on my channel as well.
Slurious
is a good
dude.
Or at least
was at some point. He's a good cutie. I'm a tree
hugger,
Steezles. That is what my profession is right now, if you can call that a profession.
Camera mode? What does that mean? Third person, first person, what? Whoa. Oh. Whoa. Alright.
First person tabletop.
So it makes it so you can't move your head. Like, you can't rotate around the table. That's... Why would you want
that? That sounds nauseating.
Yeah.
Like, you can't just shift around the table freely. Like a jackass.
Oh.
Hootie and Andrew.
I'm still thinking. Still thinking. Alrighty.
We're in Poland again, yes. Someone messaged me. They put it in the comments of the After Hours video. Apparently, one of these signs says something in Polish, so they were able to figure out that we're somewhere in Poland.
Poland?
This is... If you look around, we're in the middle of a street.
Uh-huh. We are. I see that now.
My god. Google Earth really took a downward tumble.
Alrighty.
Alright.
What do you got?
Oh, I'm going first?
Yeah, I don't know. We're going counterclockwise, right? So that would, I guess that would be.
Yeah, that would be me. Jen?
Yes.
Communing with nature, the beauty of it all, and making certain that all of these terrible companies around you don't hack down the beautiful 100 years redwoods that you come to love so much. You're hugging the tree so close. It's tangible, squishy bark pushing up against your skin. You love the tree. You wish you were the tree. You want to stay with the tree as long as you can. But here's the problem. You're fucking bored of hugging this tree for so damn long. And you had to look the part, so you dressed real light in a vest and some shorts, and you're not really sure when it's going to end. That backhoe's not going anywhere. Introducing the radio vest. You just keep holding on to that, and you can just flick it onto any channel, and you can be singing along to Paul McCartney's Little Willow waiting there for 27 hours straight while you hug the fuck out of that tree.
I got really upset because I thought you said for 127 hours straight, and I thought this was getting dark.
Alright. The radio vest.
That was very emotional.
It really was.
Tree
took me there.
I'm gonna cry a little bit.
I'm done.
Hey, son. That's
I'm,
you.
I'm Andrew. Good.
Yeah, that's it. I'm all right. I'm good. So do I go or does someone else?
No,
yeah,
it's you.
It's you. All right, buddy.
All right. Well, Jen, I'm going to call you Jen.
Please call me Jen.
Here's the thing about you, Jen. You're hugging trees. You're literally hugging trees. Your job in this America, 2016, or whatever country you're in, not to judge, is to literally wrap your arms around a tree and squeeze it, providing it with a mild amount of warmth and comfort. That is what you get paid for. Can you believe this shit? I can't either. It's incredible. However, sometimes your arms aren't good enough. What do a lot of hippies, or tree huggers as you are claiming yourself to be, resort to when protesting? Handcuffs, right? But there's a problem with handcuffs. They're made of steel. Steel is not recyclable. So instead, we're going to go all natural with the underwear handcuffs. You remember Bra?
Are you sure you're not trying? Sure you're not trying to sell her like
it's just
like bedroom things?
I hope he is, really.
Here's the fun fact about underwear handcuffs. It's literally fucking underwear handcuffs. You can do whatever you want with it. I'm not here to tell you. But the cool thing about it, do you remember in the 60s when they burned bras? And you remember in like the 90s and 2000s when they handcuffed themselves to trees? Now you can save both in one convenient place, you filthy hippie. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Let's be real. It's 2016. We just got out of a recession. Shit sucks. The radio has all these really sad songs and everything is kind of dark and it's really hard to be a hippie in these times, you know? Like, how are you supposed to be a hippie and be happy about Mother Earth and all that shit when you know that the capitalist is going to win in the end and it's going to destroy everything that you love? Enter the Hope Shield, okay? It allows you to continue to ignore reality and be happy and ignore the ills and just be able to go to Starbucks and go, yes, this is an equivalent to that place that used to be here that they tore down. Yes, this tree is still going to be okay and it won't be torn down to make another Starbucks. Hope Shield. It continues to allow you to be in a bubble of hope and joy.
Guys, I just got an achievement.
Me too.
I'm really scared.
Play the game for 1 hour without flipping the table.
Oh. Wow. That's actually kind of surprising.
I'm going to flip this table.
What you're trying to sell me is a bottle of Prozac. That's what you're trying to sell me.
It's a physical shield of happiness.
Okay.
You guys are fucking downers.
Well, you could not with the hope shield. A hope shield, but that's just protecting yourself. That's just a defense. You know, as a tree hugger, I understand what your wants and needs. You want to get shit done. You don't want to sit there and be complacent all the time. You want to be a person of action and change and take down the capitalist society that raised you. You want to bring down the system. And what better weapon to help convert your fellow man and woman with the faith hammer? You can smack them with the faith hammer and they will instantly turn to your side. No matter what you're believing in, they will believe you instantly with the faith hammer. Just give them a couple whacks across the face, maybe the kneecaps. You know, they'll get the message eventually if you just keep hitting them enough. The faith hammer, it's the only tool you'll need to convert people to your cause.
Okay, how do I tear my card in half and give half of it to Colin and half of it to Alex? Because I want the Hope Shield and the Faith Hammer so I can be a tree hugger paladin. How do I do that?
I saw the face shield, I was like, oh, she's going to become a paladin if she gets the Faith Hammer.
Can I have both? Like, is there a way?
I'm not going to lie. If you combine all this, you got the best role in Dungeons & Dragons I've ever seen.
Pretty much.
This is an incredible druid starting kit, really.
Yeah.
Underwear. I don't know about the underwear handcuffs, honestly.
Hey,
but
shut your mouth. It was a good idea when I kind of thought it was cool. I don't know.
Maybe flip a coin or roll a dice if you're not sure.
How do I decide who wins?
I don't know.
It's completely on you to decide which product you want.
But they're both part of the things that I need to be a real druid or a paladin or whatever.
Look, you can just get a hammer and smack people in the face with it. With the Hope Shield, you just don't need to hit anyone because your life is still okay.
Yeah, but you're not doing anything about... You're not changing society. You're just defending against society. With the Faith Hammer, you're actually making meaningful change. When you have the Hope Shield, you're just sitting there trying to take it. But the
literally
Faith Hammer,
activism
you can
versus inactivism.
Exactly.
Look, listen. Listen. We're all destined to die alone. You might as well be happy. Hope Shield.
But do you want to make? But you could either live your life complacent, or you can live your life knowing that you may have had some small impact on somebody.
You won't.
Steeple just said, "I have a feeling Jen will go with the hammer because the Harlequin theme." And then Bulbaneer goes, "Jen wants to play Hippie Taric, so I think I'm gonna have to give this to Alex because I want to play Hippie Taric."
I'm glad you did that. I was gonna say, "When in doubt, write it out, Pony Door."
Tony Door.
Alrighty. That was a good round.
I enjoyed it.
That makes GPM the next person. You're a vampire.
What am I? I'm a vampire.
Yes.
Oh. God, that is. Oh, shit. All of these. Okay, this is definitely going in there. That's there. Okay, not that. That sounds gross.
A vampire.
Oh, God
vampire. Damn you.
What?
Okay, vampire. I got this.
Oh, God.
Should I go with... I got super lucky. I'm gonna go with this. Fuck.
Yeah. It's. If only vampires were cooler, you know?
Well,
you don't
make
like
them.
Pirates or vampires.
I lied. Pirates are pretty good.
I hope you're lying, because pirates are great. You can't not like pirates. Captain Barbossa. He's good.
All right, if you trade me the fact that vampires have overstayed their welcome, I'll concede to you the point that pirates are pretty snatchy sometimes.
Vampires have overstayed their welcome, but originally they weren't so bad. Vampires are some of my favorite supernatural creatures, even though they're kind of, right now, kind of gay. All
right, I know how I'm going to do this one. Four.
What the fuck?
And
he's just winging it.
Five. I will figure this out.
Yeah, you can't not like Dio Brando. People are like, Dio.
See, I'm the guy, though, where it's like, I watch Fist of the North Star, and Dio's adventure, whatever, is just really gay fists. I do like both series, though. I think JoJo's is pretty good.
It really is just gay fists, though. All the characters are just to have a big gay orgy. I'm just waiting for the final chapter of the manga to be written, and the guy's just like, just kidding, they were all gay! Now they're gonna fuck! And, like, that's the end.
I mean, like, I do enjoy both series, but for real, JoJo's is completely and utterly gay Fist of the North Star. Just not even an argument.
Somebody brought up Alucard, and Alucard is actually my favorite vampire, and not the one from Castlevania, the one from Helsing.
That's a good choice.
And then you have the Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines game.
I like both of them. And that game is really boogie, but it's really good.
So, I'm first, is that right? Going counterclockwise? Yes. Alright, so you're a vampire. One of the hardest things about being a vampire is finding enough blood and not getting in trouble for it, because you don't want to have those fucking villagers coming into your house, burning your shit down. Guy comes in, and he's like, Monster, you don't belong in this world. And you're like, fucker, you don't belong in my house. But what would help is blood cup, okay? It's an infinite cup of blood.
Okay. I like
it. It's so straightforward.
it has an infinite supply of blood. from the makers of Fur Chair. There's a reason that I mentioned this.
Oh, I don't know if I.
Infinite blood.
Fur chair people. Infinite blood, you say?
Infinite chinchilla blood.
Wait, chinchilla blood?
Yeah, it's good. It's tasty. It's an exotic snack. And you don't have to. You don't have to worry about the villagers coming in and fucking up your house. Real talk.
Yeah, but last time I had chinchilla, I don't know. I'll come back to that.
Okay.
All right, next up. Andrew.
Yeah.
Hey,
Andrew.
Hi, taxi driver's in my hand for some reason. I'm trying to fix. Okay. So, you're a vampire. You are now a walking undead minstrel of the night. And that is perfectly fine, because as everyone here has correctly assumed, you are a head vampire. You know what a head vampire needs? To put my cards in the correct order, because that's backwards. Some head fluid. What is head fluid exactly? It is pure 99% fluid extracted from other head vampires. What do you do with it? What doesn't a head vampire do with it? You can clean your bathroom. You can clean your shower. You can drink it. You can eat it. You can freeze it and use it as a toy. It's your pet. It's best friend. It is literally a fluid made for you, the head vampire.
Okay.
Fucking buy it and I'll give you some blood,
I don't know if I want fluids from other head vampires. I think that's a way to make me sick, but I'll come back to that. Hoodie.
Hey, Emma.
Yeah, for me.
Let's just admit it, man. You've got this vampire thing going on, and you're a traditionalist. You're going with the full cowl, cape. You've got the red set. You are looking fucking fine. The problem is, you don't really fit in with the nightlife society. People are kind of looking at you strange, and when you're trying to bring a nice little damsel back to your castle to, get a little something from her, something just isn't right. You're just kind of putting them off. Let me show you what you need. So you need to be carrying around and letting people know about the costume prize. They're going to think that you are just dressed up as any old schmuck, and that you're going to just take them away and just go, hey, listen, you look really good tonight. I bet you could take the first place costume prize. I don't care where they are, who they are. They'll look at you and they'll go like, prize? What? Huh? Yeah? Okay. Yes. And then you drag them all the way back to your place and you just drain the living fuck out of them. The costume prize tricks anyone.
That sounds a little deceiving, to say the least, but okay.
You're blessing feet of the night.
I mean, yeah, I guess. All right, Jen, what do you got for me?
All right, so as other people have pointed out, sometimes people like to come all up into your castle, all up into your coffin, and they're getting all in your face, and you don't want that. You don't want Simul Bama riding your dick all the time.
Maybe you do.
Well, let's not jump to conclusions.
Yeah, maybe you do.
Okay, I mean, some people want that. Maybe you want that. I don't know. But assuming that you do not want this, I have the perfect product for you from the makers of Pocket Sand. I have Cape Peach. All right? So instead of pulling sand out of your pocket and throwing it, you can, since you're already wearing a cape, since you're a vampire, you just throw an entire beach of sand on somebody if they're bothering you. Cape Beach. Endorsed by Dale Gribble.
I do trust Rusty Shackleford.
Damn.
Well, let's go through here. You had me on Blood Cup for a while, Red, but then you said it was chinchilla blood. And,
look, you can hold other blood in it.
Are you kidding me? Chinchillas again?
You missed the chinchilla part of that? I've got a lot of chinchilla blood. I've been skinning them for fur chairs. What do you want me to do?
I'm sorry. I don't.
What animal head shelter fluid website has your girlfriend made you be looking at?
Head fluid, while I appreciate the compliment of calling me a head vampire, I don't know really what I would do with fluid of other
can
head vampires.
Some fluid head instead.
That sounds a little sexual, and being a vampire, I may be into fluid head, but I don't, his original pitch was head fluid, so.
You're right.
No, I don't know about that. Costume prize sounded a little dark.
You're a fucking vampire, though. You can kill
your fucking product is an idea.
I know. Is it the best? You just soap people
not
like
even the goddamn thing. So much.
Cape Beach.
Now Cape Beach. I liked Cape Beach for the fact that it's just a literal cape full of sand. And as a vampire, I do like my capes. So this is really a tough one. I think I can eliminate costume prize because that just sounds a little mean. I mean, I'm a vampire, but I'm not a savage.
That's why you need a locally well-sourced blood cup.
I'm not a savage.
Couldn't deny the power of the beast that is coming out of my cape.
Really? I'm not drinking chinchilla blood. I'm not drinking chinchilla blood, so I'm gonna go with Cape Beach.
Yes.
Because, you know, if those guys come up to me with their knives and pitchforks, I can just throw sand in their eyes and then fly away into bat form.
Exactly. That's what I was going for.
Can we not draw pictures of me in a chinchilla fursuit?
Or you could.
I believe I'm up
next,
right?
I mean, you love chinchillas so much, Rev.
I think the chinchilla throwback really sealed the deal for you, dude.
I should not have referred
to... I was all on board until the...
Yeah. Oh shit! I would have would have gotten it. Damn.
Oh, secret admirer.
Secret. Oh.
I have a lover. Oh. I need to.
No,
I need to tell my special someone that I like them, but I also need to be on the down low.
Done, and fucking done, and done.
Maybe a little bit yandere. It's okay, though. I'll fucking kill for senpai.
Wow. Senpai is everything.
Senpai is life.
Sounds all right. A little wooden, a little cultish.
Look, have you seen senpai? I'll fucking kill you.
Which senpai?
My senpai.
Which one?
Senpai.
Who? Just every senpai.
Just specifically
that could be
senpai.
Anyone, though.
Andrew, you're up first. Sell me a thing.
Oh shit! Okay. From the makers of the Fantastic Fabulous Secret Admirer comes your one and only favorite, Diamond Man. He's a man made out of solid diamond, and goddammit, he is pure 24 carats of stone-cold love. He'll break into your house in the middle of the night and present you with a whole casket of bouquet flowers. He'll give you chocolates even when you don't want them. You think your dad's gonna be afraid of him? Well, too bad, because he is. The Diamond Man, the only secret admirer you'll ever need.
He would be hard all the time. Hootie?
That was not what I was going for, but I like it.
Hootie.
Yes, he also has a solid diamond penis, if you're like that, I guess.
Well, you're that looking... hurt, like, a lot. Like, a lot.
You're looking to impress the one that you like. You just really don't know how to sell that really boring-ass Hallmark card and to really seal the deal there. You got their address, and you want to send them something that you know that they'd appreciate, something that shows vigor and passion, something that holds them in and draws them close to you and makes them understand, really, who you are. From GPM Industries, I introduce to you the muscle carpet. The muscle carpet has muscles all over the fucking carpet, showing exactly how strong you are, how passionate you can be. And just after you tell her to just leave the house for about, I don't know, 4 or 5 fucking hours, and you carpet the entire place full with bulging biceps and ripped triceps, she's going to come home, and she's never going to know what hit her. The muscle carpet. Even this guy over here can't disagree with me.
Okay, Jen.
From the makers of Diamond.
How dare you?
It's
my brand.
I will tell you what hit her. Van Desk. All right, so you're sitting in class and you're admiring
what?
The person that you love, and you are passing to Van Desk. But jokes on your cheek to you're the person you're admiring because you are actually a Van Desk. So now all you have to do is drive that Van Desk right into the person that you're admiring, knock them the fuck out, throw them into the Van Desk, and you're gone.
That's...
Wow!
So it'll allow me to easily kidnap Senpai.
We finally found an item that applies to literally every category. Vampire? Van Desk. Pirate? Van Desk. Senior? Van Desk.
Okay, GPM, you've got some hard contenders, you know? Okay,
before I begin my pitch, Rev,
yeah.
Could you do me a favor?
Yeah.
Just imagine I'm walking into the presentation room to present to you with a boombox at this point. Okay. I need you to play this song.
Okay.
Can you do that for me?
Okay.
Then back and let me know when you're playing it.
Okay, so it's Night Call by Kavansky. I'm going to try and not get copyright strike, but I can hum the melody.
Sure, that might work too.
You can do the Space Jam remix if you ever need an out.
It's a good song. You should go.
Oh, so it's a late night. You're thinking about your crush, and you want to confess to her, but you don't know how to do it. So you drive up to her house, looking stunning, wearing your blazer. You're driving there thinking you look like the hotness from, like the driver from Drive.
The new hotness.
You come up to her door. She answers. You look at her and say nothing because you're also acting like the guy from Drive because he doesn't talk a lot. And she asks you how you're doing, but you respond with this, a night kiss. You bring her in close for the night kiss and you give her the night kiss and you take her away in your car and you drive away back to your place and you lay her down for another night kiss. And you're night kissing all night.
That's drug someone in
such a way. It's not a kidnap. It's a night kiss.
Is that what you said in your court testimony?
Yeah.
So I've got two tools for. Darkness. I've got two insane things and then two ways of kidnapping people.
I'm giving you a night kiss.
Yeah.
Telling you how I feel.
Fuck, it's between the Van Desk and the Night Kiss, and Night Kiss is honestly getting a lot of love because of the whole Kavansky reference.
Night Kiss, tell you
Kavansky,
how I
you know
feel.
Van Desk. Listen, you can do a Night Call and run her over with a Van Desk. Or him.
But can you tell her how you feel with a night kiss? You can.
Yes, after you've knocked her or him out and thrown her into the van.
There's nothing dark. There's nothing dark about a van desk.
I think just
everything's dark in a van.
I think just kidnapping someone is more my style. Like honestly.
Yes.
Okay, you horrible person.
Look, I've got a lot of chinchillas in my desk. It's the back of my van desk, and I don't know what to do with them, okay?
If only you just bought the muscle carpet, this wouldn't be a problem.
The muscle carpet is just creepy.
About you, boy.
Van desk meets all of Colin's needs, all of them, including the chinchilla-related ones.
Oh my
but
god.
With Night Kiss, you can actually become Ryan Gosling.
Isn't Ryan Gosling really considered attractive still? I haven't looked at him recently.
I don't know. I haven't looked at him in a long time, but...
That's a really hurtful thing to say about me.
Kind of looks like someone took his chin and just kept pulling it downward a lot and didn't stop.
So he turned into the mask?
Sure. What are you, Andrew? You can't sleep.
I can't sleep. My cats are making too much references.
Ryan Gosling's an okay-looking guy. I just googled his face. Here's a picture of him without teeth for some reason. I don't know why this happened. There's just a picture of him. It looks like he has no teeth. I'm going to post it in chat so you guys can see.
How do you rotate cards?
You can hold them and then use the scroll wheel.
Gotcha.
Okay, so we're selling the Insomniac thing.
Baby Gosling. Oh, baby. He twives.
I
accidentally dealt. I didn't mean to do that.
It's okay. I've got all the ones I need now. I think I have more than I need, actually. I don't know where the fuck... Is it this one? I think it was this one.
Oh, yeah. Someone gave me an extra one?
Yeah.
I think Ben drew
for a while. Oh, I was looking at Baby Gosling because I really want to jingle my car keys at him, but this was my extra. Where am I putting it?
Just put it in the stack here. Where am I?
Okay. There you go. Oops.
I'm giving you a night kiss to tell you how I feel.
He's obsessed with Night Kiss.
Night Call is a good song, though.
Talking.
Tessalorosa auto drive.
I need you a Chuck E. Cheese. You give me your tokens. You have 5 games. Otherwise, I weave. I drive.
I drive.
Just imagine that in the context of the movie.
His fucking backseat is literally loaded with tickets.
Like the drivers come in. Or like the robbers come in and it's just baby Ryan Gosling sitting in a high chair trying his fucking car.
In the beginning, when he's hiding in the street, right. Fucking cop picks him up. Are you lost, little man?
I drive, and then the cop just shakes his jingle keys. He's like, "Oh, you drive? Do you want your jingle keys?"
Oh fuck! Water's everywhere. Oh god.
Why have you done this?
I just spilled water. Alright. Andrew is an insomniac, apparently.
I can't sleep. If only some really terrible salesman could try and sell me some useless shit.
Like,
and then afterwards, I'll play a game of snake oil.
You're staying up late watching infomercials, and this is what you're gonna see.
Fuck.
Even you a night kiss.
Please.
Okay.
Maybe you could suck up some of that water with a night kiss.
Maybe you could suck S-U-C-C.
Sook? Hey, you mean sook?
Hey,
sook.
You need that water out of your place? You know what a good way to get it out is? Pony door.
What the fuck with a pony door?
I really like pony door.
Pony door.
And I really liked Gun Robot, but we can't get what we want.
It's true.
Okay, I got mine. Do you guys...
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
What are you, Insomniac?
Insomniac. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, right.
Yeah, we're playing a game still. We're going best of 5, right?
How professional.
I'm sorry, what? I was too busy. What?
Andrew is an insomniac.
Too busy with a night kiss?
It's like
Don't
fucking...
Don't tell me you gave me a night kiss.
No, night I gave kiss. It to Jin.
Everything's wrong with the night kiss.
From the makers of Roof and All, it's Night Kiss.
It sounds so much friendlier.
It does. I mean, that's why it's called Roofies.
I guess Roofies is sound nicer.
Roofies is the kid version of fucking Roof and All. Hey, Billy, try this. It's called Roofies.
Jesus.
I don't know about a roofie. Well, how about a night kiss? Oh, okay.
What did you give to me there, man? I drive.
You know that scene in Drive when he's like beating the shit out of those people in the elevator?
Yeah.
Or was that like outside?
He's curb stomping a mobster's face.
You still need to watch that.
But
movie.
It's just that. But it's just a, like a little baby. Oh my god. Drive is so good.
Y'all ready?
Drive is actually a really strong movie.
I've heard it is, and it was part of the inspiration for Hotline Miami, which I love.
Mm-hmm.
So, Hoots.
I mean, it's counterclockwise, right?
Yeah, that would be Hoots, right?
So then, yeah, it's Hoots.
Is Hootie giving a night kiss?
I'm counter, because...
Yeah, from...
Okay, that's clockwise. Roy,
is
it?
Wait. Sorry.
It.
I had way too many night kisses. Rev.
Okay. So your main problem as an insomniac is trying to get to sleep, but you can't, right? What if you could just turn off your brain? What if you could just get really fucking high? That would help, right? Space cap. It sends your brain to space, okay?
Is it like a hat?
It's a hat that gets you really high so you can go to sleep. It's like taking NyQuil, but it's a hat, and you go to space.
It's like taking NyQuil, but you're not robo-tripping. But you are.
Yes.
Hmm. Now, does it send me to actual space, or like...
Let's get twisted, man.
Look, you
No. In the wise words of DMX, don't get it twisted, but... Does
don't
it
get it twisted.
Actual space? Or, like, theoretical drug space? That's very important. I can't breathe in space.
Well, it's okay, because you're in drug
it's
space.
Not
you really
a fucking gang!
You wouldn't know the difference.
All right, good. Rev, that's great. It's not what you heard. It's what you hear. And please, Alex.
Oh, wait, am I up?
Yes.
It's all you, buddy.
It's all you,
baby. I'm sorry, I was distracted by DMX's sweet tones. Okay, so...
Well,
you're Insomniac. He'll deliver to you, if you know what I'm saying. And you know what else I'm going to deliver to you, my good friend? The pleasure bazooka. That should be pleasure bazooka. So, you're up late at night.
I have one
and,
of
you
those.
Know, you're trying to get to sleep. You're trying to get to sleep. But you're just not able to relax and enjoy yourself and, you know, maybe pleasure yourself. But the only reason is because the kids across the hall are being loud or they're pleasuring something. Or maybe you have neighbors upstairs. They're in a band. They're in a thrash metal band. They're banging around. They're making it hard for you to sleep. Well, with the pleasure bazooka, you can shoot things at them, and that'll give you the pleasure of peace and quiet. And then you'll be able to sleep or pleasure yourself.
I think
that's
going to
go
dick.
Really well with my friend Charger.
With the friend Charger.
The pleasure bazooka.
Pleasure bazooka.
It'll get you excited and get you that sweet relief you've always craved. To help
that's what
them
Alex
go to sleep.
Calls his dick.
So basically, if I combine the space cap with the pleasure bazooka, I'm instigating Ragnarok.
Basically, well, you really only need the pleasure bazooka.
You won't
amazing.
Know what's happening.
Amazing.
It'll be great.
I like it. Jen, if you please.
Certainly. So instead of sleeping, how about never sleeping again? Stay with me here. So I present you Powderball. I'm not saying it's heroin.
Oh, no.
I'm not saying it's cocaine. I'm saying it's both. Listen.
Oh, my God.
From the makers of Giggle Spray, huh?
Yeah, from the makers of Giggle Spray, Powderball is filled with a lot of magical components that will ensure that you never sleep again. So you can continue living the insomniac life that you desire. And it's all you need. You'll never sleep again, I promise. I've tried it. It's great. I haven't slept ever. Can't remember the last time it happened. It's not even as expensive as
other things.
So
far, my cures for insomnia are drugs, more drugs, and weaponized masturbation.
Yes.
I mean, I kind of want to be an actual insomniac now. Hootie! Hootie! You fine man person, please do it.
402, 403, 404, you won't stop. The clawing won't fucking stop. The drapes are shredded in the other room and they still won't fucking stop. The yowling continues to happen and I just can't
I don't
think
like this
anymore. I get up from the couch and I go down into the basement. I rip open the sack of seed. I'm a farmer. I have a very honest and very stable life, but I can't fucking rest. I take the garbage up to the top of the stairs where the cats are in the room and they're scratching at the thing and I take them and I put them in the sack and I hit them against the wall and I hit them against the wall and I hit them against the wall because that's all I needed, the seed sack.
Whoa, that was really intense.
That was fucking dark. What was that?
No, you guys were like promoting murder implements at some point. I'm just doing the same thing.
Yeah, but
just
you
saying.
Did it in a way that made me scared.
It's really
like,
not the same thing.
I made killing chinchillas sound fun.
Those are the thoughts Hootie gets whenever he loses matches in Street Fighter, honestly. I'm throwing my controller against the wall over and over.
So we got drugs, weaponized masturbation, more drugs, and more masturbation. Got it.
I can attest to the usefulness of the seed sack. Hootie's used it on me twice.
Fate.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
Okay.
Hootie's fiance.
Who wins this one?
Jeez.
I mean, we have testimony from Hootie's fiance.
All right, I'm gonna be dead fucking blunt like a crowbar with all of you. I liked all of these a lot. However, if I'm bored and I can't fucking sleep, I'm going to at least make myself not want to kill myself, unlike you sick fucks. Alex, take the card.
Oh my god.
He is the only one who brought some joy in his existence instead of pure unrelenting darkness.
Heart thugs bring a lot of joy to a lot of people.
Ask Ray Charles. Oh wait, you can't. He's dead.
I mean, so is John Belushi, and God rest his soul, I love him, but...
Yeah, that's true. He was more...
Hootie, I will say, I absolutely loved your pitch for...
It was fucked up beyond all belief.
Like, bonus special points to Hootie. That was incredible. But in terms of what I want to buy, I gotta go play
it. Progressively got darker and darker, and I
completely understand. I would have made me leave.
If it was like another
advanced level darkness
thing, I would.
Oh wow, I'm a teacher.
Yes, Rudy is a teacher.
This is realistic.
Okay,
this is very realistic.
Oh my god,
you should give me teaching things.
This is.
Oh, I'll teach you something.
Alex knew what he wanted like instantly.
Yeah,
like,
I got this.
Those cards, like fate moved his hand, and they just appeared.
All right.
Jen's
I got
calculating
this.
About it, though. I gotta be honest. I'm more scared of what Jen's thinking because I think she's cooking up something like a storm.
Or I'm just having.
She's only had one very violent one, and that one. Didn't it?
None of mine have ever been violent.
Yeah.
And she's beating all of us right now. So.
Yes.
None of my cards have ever been violent.
All of them
have been masturbatory, like they're like
pleasure plug.
That's just him in general.
Oh lord, God, I can't.
Pleasure
for
plug.
For a teacher, I'm
say.
Trying to think.
Do you teach like school or on a farm? Because if you're on a farm, I have an idea.
What?
It has to do with a pony door, doesn't it?
Fuck.
I got you, bitch.
I mean, no. That's weird. Yeah. Who would ever say that?
I'm gonna try to. I don't know.
Tie knife wasn't a weapon. It was a utility.
Tie knife is.
It was directly a weapon. That was your suggestion for my use of it.
It was a weapon.
That was just one use you could maybe possibly use it for.
That was the only thing that differentiated it from a normal tie.
No. No, not really.
Okay, well.
It had stripes.
Andrew, I think I'm doing this right. It's you. It's you, my friend.
Hey there, Odie. How's it going?
Pretty good.
You're a teacher, right? That's good.
You don't have to put your armor on me. It's okay.
I'm going to make your job a hell of a lot easier.
Okay.
You see, when you're a teacher, there's a thing that you need to learn about kids and about yourself.
Uh-huh.
They sometimes got to go to the bathroom.
They actually do.
It's a real shame. Because here's the thing. In Japan, they eliminated going to the bathroom entirely. Now, their productivity is up 620%.
Christ.
That's why I give to you something that'll make your life a little easier in that regard. The toilet diaper. Because now, if you shit your diaper... It's got somewhere to go, baby.
You're giving me so much Nicolas Cage right now. Oh my god.
Yeah, I was kind of feeling a bit of Nick Cage.
And after I give you this toilet diaper, I'm gonna go steal the Declaration of Independence.
Dude, that's a really fucking good Nick Cage. Oh my god.
I used to actually do impressions throughout high school.
I'm okay with this. I don't need to see the rest of your cards. Nicolas Cage just won this round.
Hold up.
Hold up.
I got this. Some kids are shit.
God, you're right.
Syringe pool.
Okay.
I'm afraid I don't understand.
Please.
It's like in the Saw movie when there was that pool full of syringes. And they were like, you're a drug addict, you're going in. It's like, oh, shit.
It's exactly like Saul. It's a learning method. You're a piece of shit? Listen, you need to stop being a piece of shit. Throw him in the syringe pool. Taken from the pages of Saul. This learning method taught the shit out of that character. And what happened to them? They died. And now you don't have to deal with that kid. Or they live and they don't act like a jackass anymore.
I gotta say, you are the four weirdest kidnappers I've ever been with, but I'll still listen to the rest. Alex, if that is your name,
okay.
Please
yes.
Tell me more.
Okay, before I begin my pitch, Andrew.
What's up?
Andrew, could you say I'm gonna steal the Declaration of Independence again, please?
Yes, please.
Sure. Alright. See, the thing... Hang on. I gotta like, get into it, because Nick Cage is kind of that weird, like, amalgamation of sort of an actor.
We gotta steal the Declaration of Independence.
And then can you all say right. We're gonna take their face off?
You gotta be kidding me when you're saying this to me. You mean we're gonna take their faces off? I can't deal with taking their faces off!
Can you scream the bees?
Ah, not the bees! Ah!
Oh, God.
Okay, quit your day job. I'm hiring you to just say this shit to me all day. That's it.
Like practicing
friends and
stuff. A lot of
them
stuff.
I love it. That was beautiful.
Okay, my pitch.
Yeah.
Hey, Hootie.
Hi. What's with the ASMR voices? So, he's a teacher.
Shh. So, you know, you're a teacher, right? How did you get into your job? How did you become a teacher?
Bad decisions. You untie me a little. This hurts my wrists.
Listen, you know, do you like children? Do you like kids?
Yeah.
Okay.
But fucking day with them. What's your point?
Sometimes you get a couple bad apples in there, right?
Syringe pool.
Sometimes you gotta take them to detention, right?
Sure. Yeah.
But sometimes detention isn't enough, and sometimes you need a more permanent solution. Enter the murder kit. It has all the tools you need to permanently deal with troublemakers. Knives, swords, battle axes, syringes, poisons.
Everything you make kills someone.
But this is a whole kit full of it, baby. If you ever have a bad apple you really need to take care of, well, this has got it. And trust me, I can hook you up on a good deal of it, if you know what I want. Forget a syringe bowl, that's too cumbersome. You need to set that up. This is just a little box of tools. You know, it may even have a gun robot in there if you really want it.
I was gonna ask.
You know, that's.
I've heard those are really terrible and they don't work that well.
Yeah.
It's you know, by choice. You can build your own murder kit, however you want.
Jan, you look the least bloodthirsty. Please sell me something I can use with children.
Okay.
A box with a knife in it.
Yes. So, assuming you don't want to go to jail for molesting or killing any children, I have the thing for you, and you can actually go doubles with a toilet diaper and my product. So pretty much what you do is you strap the toilet diaper onto the children, and then you throw them into the tickle tent. That's right. If you don't want to deal with their bullshit anymore, you
can. I think that should win, like, solely based on alliteration.
You can just be like, bitch, bye! Throw them into the tickle tent, and if they have the toilet diaper on, then if they piss themselves from getting tickled and laughing too hard, you don't have to clean up any messes, so it's all good. And you can win Teacher of the Year, and nobody's dead.
Okay, here's the deal. Okay. I drive you to the tickle tent.
Listen. Fuck children. Syringe pool.
Don't fuck kids, though.
Not literally. Figuratively.
I don't know. I like the alliteration on Jen's, because alliteration, you could say, tickles my fancy.
I can only really hope like that there's a Twitch admin well. Sitting in chat going like, what the fuck?
What are these guys talking about?
I'm sorry, everyone. I honestly, a weird and funny round. I have to give to Jen. I love the tickle tent.
Yay!
Tickle tent is beautiful.
The alliteration sold it.
I thought syringe pool was just simply fucking perfect.
Thank
Somebody
you.
Said, meet me in the tickle tent.
That was.
Let's open up this tickle tent!
Like, Rev, you win for just saying the most.
All right, guys, here's the plan. We're going to steal the Magna Carta, and then you need to both meet me in the tickle tent. No!
If I ever meet Nicolas Cage, I'm going to get him to say that exact line, so help me.
That's pretty good. I'll give you that.
Dude, you're already meeting him today. He's here.
Oh my god, I know.
My secret, Jen? I've hidden this.
Did I just give you too many cards? Shit, I'm sorry.
You gave me two. Yeah. I was pulling my own. You're all these in discard.
Who's next? Jen. You are a astronaut.
That's fun.
Damn. Mm.
Wow. All of these are awful.
Some hype.
Someone just subscribed?
So you're an astronaut?
Trainer Alexia. Hey, it's you. Thank you. I know Trainer Alexia.
Oh, hey, Tino.
They do lots of good art and are good peoples.
Yes, they do. Thank you, Tino. Astronaut.
Oh, fuck. That's you, right, Andrew? The lone noob?
Yeah, that's me.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Yeah. I don't know how there's any way to point that out. It's really awkward that it's a different name, but whatever.
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 The art of Nick Cage in a tickle tent.
Coming this summer. If you thought that you've seen Nicolas Cage at his lowest of lows, be prepared for the tickle tent.
Everyone wants me to do something
Sunday,
with
Sunday. Sunday, the tickle tent.
Gwen Stefani, Pee Wee Herman.
See your favorite streamers fight it out in the Tickle Tent featuring GPM and Rev Scarecrow as they battle with gun robots inside the Tickle Tent. Watch as the Undertaker and a 7-year-old boy face off in a tag match versus a milkman and Diane the Librarian.
Okay, I think I got this. This is dumb, right? But astronaut. I mean...
Astronaut. Okay, wait, who's the astronaut?
I'm the astronaut.
Hold on.
I have to remember what mine is. Hold
on.
Okay.
I don't know.
Coming this summer, Pee Wee Herman, Gwen Stefani, Limp Bizkit, in the greatest tag team match you've ever seen.
Why are you trying to play me in the tickle tent? Other than all for the tickle.
The what?
I don't know what to do with you guys.
Punk Maniac, thank you for subscribing. It has been a good day.
Punk Maniac.
Coming this summer. Sub for the Tickle Tent.
Sub.
All subscribers
summer.
Of Red Scarecrow's channel will be invited this Sunday to the Tickle Tent.
Tickle Tent.
Coming this summer, it's Sean Connery in the Tickle Tent 2. Oh, you seem to be putting me in this Tickle Tent.
Fucking why?
Well, Ashy, what you don't know is that the tent's gonna tickle you right back.
Lord. Oh, God. Alright, so Jen's an astronaut.
Summer, Sean Connery and...
I'm an astronaut, yes.
Nicolas Cage.
What did you do to these cards over here? My God.
Whoa. That was very quick and easy.
Thanks.
Hootlord, I believe you're first.
Yes. Oh, I am. All right. Let me think.
Is this a movie or a WrestleMania event? It's probably both. Yeah. It's a pay-per-view event.
You're a fashionable woman and you want to go to space. You want to look your best on the way up there, so you put on your nicest skirt as you go up into the heavens. The problem is... you don't have really a way to keep it down. Zero gravity and all that shit is a real drag. But you know what can help you out here? The skirt brick. The skirt brick will make sure that it keeps everything down the way it needs to be. And then you keep your, prudence, I suppose. The skirt brick.
Hootie, I'm going to disqualify you right here because that's an actually useful invention.
I'm sorry. I did my best.
How dare you?
How dare you?
Meet me in the tickle tent in 5 furlongs.
Hootie's assuming I'm not a space whore.
I guess that was an assumption I made.
For
From He's the assuming that I want to be a lady. Comes
Space Whores.
Ice Cube and Nick Cage go on a camping trip with the WWE superstars and find love with some casual tickling.
Mr. Cube, I don't understand. I brought the tickle tent all the way here and you're not even going to get in.
If I could do Ice Cube, I'd keep it going, but...
I don't even know what the dude sounds like, to be honest.
I don't even know how
stereotypical gangster rapper, but like a really old one.
So a little bit dad-like, but also...
Like, kind of like, alright, he's the kind of gangster rapper where at this point in his life, if he sees one of his friends get fucked up drunk, instead of going, yeah, that's the best, he's gonna go, man, what the fuck? I gotta clean up this shit. He's that kind of guy.
Okay.
He's become a dad.
Yeah. He's more fatherly advice instead of getting crunk.
Andrew.
Very deadly.
Yeah, what's up?
Okay. Crunk or crump?
What you got?
Alright, Junie. You're just in time for your magical adventure into space. But once Holy you shit. Get there, you've got to remember that space is quite chilly, cold, frozen even. So what's going to keep you warm during all those spacey
Are you, Stamper, space is that you? Nights? Yeah.
Yeah, actually it is.
It's the scarf socks. For when you need some socks on your scarf and a scarf on your socks. The scarf socks.
All right, I love the Stamper that you injected in there. I have to give you points for that, because that's great.
Thank you.
Oh, okay, so with the skirt brick, they're assuming that you don't want to get some action in space. But let's get real. Some people, they will go to space because they want to get some action. You want to get some of that astronaut dick. Let me explain. Sometimes, just going to space isn't enough for you. You got to get grounded. You got to learn, you got to like get into your own fetishes. Introducing the foot poster. Okay?
No.
What?
Sorry, I'm dying.
It's no. Okay. You like feet? No. You're interested in feet?
No.
Sexually, perhaps? And space, perhaps. Foot poster. From the makers of I Already Used My Space Card.
Oh my god.
Well, I don't know what kind of smut Rev is trying to peddle to you, but you know it gets lonely out in space. It gets lonely out in space sometimes, and sometimes you need to really remember where your heart lies. You have a husband back home who really cares about you, but unfortunately you lost your ring out in space. Oh no!
No.
What are you ever gonna do? Well, that's why. Instead of a normal ring, you could just get a ring tattoo. You can get a tattoo of your old ring right where it used to be, and so you can remember your loving and caring husband and how you loved to do the things with him that you so did and not put up a foot poster because that's weird and you're a normal person.
Are you a normal person, though? Are you into feet?
I mean...
I like a good foot rub. I don't think I have a foot fetish, so I don't know if I would want a foot poster to masturbate to in space.
I can just get you ready for space dick.
No!
I'm always ready for space dick, okay? I was born ready. So fine. I don't know if I need warm-up material in space, but I do need material to warm up my feet in space. So where are you
going
for those?
Oh my god.
And also the Stamper impression kind of won me over a little bit.
Won that round.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna stop doing impressions because that's cheating.
I mean,
you're a salesman, you have to use whatever you have available to you.
Yeah.
I mean, I have various guns, so I'd use those.
I'm a runaway. Help me.
You're a runaway.
A runaway.
All right, important distinction. Are you a train or a
runaway American dream? Yeah. I'm on the run.
You're a runaway.
I'm not
going
that song.
Runaway train, never come back.
Someone says Jen,
I kind of want to take that sample. Sorry, go ahead.
No, it's fine.
Oh, sorry. Who's talking? What's going on?
All right, I was gonna make a dumb joke. I want to take the sample of you saying I'm always ready for space dick and turn it into like a trance mix.
Please do, because I would love that.
We'll see. We'll see how it goes.
If you have any spare time, go for it. All power to you. Someone was, Windtalker was asking me in chat, and I responded to them in text, but I don't know if they saw. They're asking me how my Stardew Valley playthrough is going, and I've been playing that game for like 300 hours, and I can't get enough of that shit. So there's that. You guys still need to play that game.
I was considering picking it up sometime soon.
You really should. It's excellent.
From the makers of the Tickle Tent and Nicolas Cage comes the Ticklish Cage.
The Nick Cage. The Nickel Cage.
I love your laugh, GPM.
It's good.
It's so good.
How much do I need to pay somebody to put Nicolas Cage inside the Ticklish Cage? It's just a cage with a bunch of like little like hands that come out and like tickle him.
Ew. No, come on.
I'm gonna echo that ew, to be honest.
I'm gonna echo an oh like, in there.
Like not in a sexual way, it's just
Jen,
Andrew,
what you got?
I've been thinking Andrew, this whole time. I'm sorry. What's up?
No, Andrew, I need you to do me a favor.
Yeah, what's up, baby?
Can you say please stop? Please get me. Can you say please get me Nicolas Cage out of this Nicolas Cage in your Nicolas Cage voice?
All right, here's the plan, gang. We need to go inside of there and get the documents out. But the problem with that is that they've upgraded their security. The problem is that they've installed a tickle cage. I've never dealt with one like this before. No! Get me out of the tickle cage!
Oh my god.
What the fuck is this stream?
Thank you.
I don't know what you're talking about. This is like fucking...
No, this is what they come for.
Me on stream.
You know, every time I go on Netflix, I feel like I see a new Nicolas Cage movie I haven't seen. Just the other day, I watched, Oh, fuck, what the hell is the name of the movie? I've just been going on a Nicolas Cage rampage recently. I think it was called Rage. I think it was called Rage, and it was a good movie.
Mm-hmm.
Counterclockwise would be.
He played a cop and he was trying to get revenge.
Was that another sub?
His daughter.
Nikolai Wolf, yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
And B just resubscribed. Thank you as well.
And welcome to the Tickle Cage.
Welcome to the Tickle Cage. The Tickle Cage.
The Tickle Cage.
This is really just like a meme generator.
You've been stopped by running to the room of the Tickle Cage. And then you will enter the dark forest.
Oh, no.
Now, one as a kid that always pissed me off was, and then you'll be in the Shrine of the Silver Monkey.
God,
kids were fucking dumb.
Because they could never do the goddamn monkey. All right, Purple Penguins, get your fucking shit together. It's three pieces.
It's three pieces. Know, there's right? only... Okay,
it's really and not that hard.
The guy watching it and spectating it is like, he's having trouble on the monkey. I can't put the monkey together.
I found out something about that show.
Yeah.
What they would apparently do is before they would actually film and air the show, they would have the kids like run around and do like a bunch of warm-ups, but basically they would try to tire the kids out as much as possible before they would actually like throw them in.
So that way they'd be just exhausted so they couldn't do shit?
Yeah.
So they couldn't win that sweet-ass Walkman?
That's kind of fucked up. What the hell?
Also, they would film like 6 or 7 episodes in like one sitting.
Well, yeah, if you actually do that.
Yeah, so if you, like, watch a bunch of episodes in a row, you'll see, like, the announcer dude is, like, wearing the same clothes for, like, 6 or 7 episodes.
All right, I swear, I got inside this hidden temple assuming that the Treaty of Versailles would have been in here, but all I found is the Shrine of the Silver Monkey. I can't put these three pieces together, and oh, the Tickle Cage!
I mean...
Fopples sub.
Fopples did sub.
Yay, someone likes us enough to give money.
Yay!
This is how fan fiction gets born, you guys.
I will write fan fiction of everyone in this room right now if you fucking attempt it.
Only, I have one stipulation. I have two stipulations. Nicolas Cage is involved and the Tickle Cage is involved.
The Tickle Tent.
It was actually going to be called Nick Cage's Rage in the Tickle Cage.
Jen, save us from this.
The problem is that I have a mechanical keyboard, so if I actually do this, you're just going to hear click clacking out the ass.
Oh, I have a mechanical keyboard too.
Oh, well, that's cute.
I got the K70.
I have a K70 as well. What color switches, my boy?
Ooh, red.
Oh my god, we're the same person.
Oh my
twinsies.
God.
You remember that show?
Oh my god.
You remember that Disney show about the twins and they like met up and they were both sisters and it said that one word twice? You know what I'm talking about?
You can say the names.
Yeah.
Of...
No. That's So Raven. Yeah, that was a good show.
It was
good.
Yeah. All right, maybe we should actually play this game now.
Jen.
Oh, fuck.
What you got?
I think it's Jen's turn.
All right. So.
He's a runaway.
You're a runaway. Yes, you're a runaway. So, what is your go-to escape vehicle?
Van
dust?
Van, maybe? I don't know.
Wrong. It's a kitten wagon. Is it a wagon full of kittens? It could be if you want it to be. Is it a kitten the size of a wagon? Sure, you can climb on its back like Clifford the Big Red Dog and ride that bitch into the sunset. Is it the giant kitten pulling a wagon, which is your skateboard? Sure. It's whatever you want it to be. Kitten wagon.
Oh my god. You guys are gonna
have to try hard.
Your life.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Oh boy, we got stealth competition.
That's fucking hard.
The problem with the kitten wagon.
There
is
are
that
no
keeps
problems
you tied
with the kitten
down.
Wagon.
You need shelter, food, you need water for the tiny kitten or the big kitten, depending on what your view is. And the problem is, you were born to be free. You were born to go across these lands and to just explore. And as lovely as a kitten may be, there are many kittens out there in that world. So you're going to get right inside that singular freedom wheel that you've been keeping together, and you're going to ride to the fucking edge of that sunset. You're going to break that horizon, and you're going to see so many sights, you're going to forget about that singular kitten, and you're going
to I'd like to imagine... Oh, my God. I'd like to imagine, as you're pitching right now, just that... Baby, We're Born to Run is playing in the background.
Mm-hmm.
I want to imagine that as you ride it, you get like halfway to Dakota, and you just look at some dude on the street and go, "Can you push me?"
Mm-hmm.
But then as soon as he pushes you, like fireworks, flags, fucking Born to Be American, like, oh my god, Hulk Hogan riding a tricycle coming over. Oh man, beautiful.
Yeah. All right, Andrew. That sounds pretty good. All right, Andrew, what do you got?
Well... You're a runaway. That means that you've run away. It means you don't have a home. So what are you, as many homeless people these day and age in this trendy modern world, going to do for various food
stuff? I mean, I'm not homeless. I'm just a runaway.
It's okay. Because the fact of the matter is that if you are a runaway, you need resources. Fine, I'll concede you the point. Maybe you can scrounge together a nice mattress underneath a Home Depot box to live in. That's cool. But the fact of the matter is that you need a way to get the things you need. In this trendy, modernized world, what is the number one way that lazy, worthless people do that? Various crowdsourcing. That's why when you gotta go to the grocery store, you're gonna get yourself some crowd milk.
Milk?
It's milk.
Again with the five steps to the...
You're crowdsourcing milk.
Crowdsourcing milk. Shortened to crowd
milk. Why don't I just put up a Kickstarter for milk?
I mean, if I had Kick milk, we'd go with that. But
guys, we found out this brand new technology inside cows. It's called milk, and with your help, we can create machines that will milk them for us.
Holy.
Thank you,
H.P. Windy. I mispronounced your name, but thank you for subscribing. Today has been a good day for me. Thank you guys so much.
The point is that you got, like, various, like, pay per months. You got, like, donates. You got, like, stretch goals, whatever. This is crowd milk. Get a crowd together. Get some milk.
What are your stretch goals?
At $400, we will turn it into yogurt. At $500, we will make cheese. And at our most popular goal, which we've already met 50 times over, at $1,000, we will shut this program down forever.
Oh no.
People aren't really fans of crowd milk, as it turns out.
How can I buy a product that has no faith? I think you just killed your pitch. All right, Rev, let's go.
Okay, so why did you run away? Because you wanted to throw killer parties, but your parents wouldn't let you. That's a problem, because you still need to throw killer parties, but you don't have a house to throw killer house parties in. Enter.
That's true.
The party blanket, okay?
Hold on. I feel like party blanket has been a thing before.
Switch it to blanket party. You're good.
Hide under the blanket. Have a party. What kind of party? I don't know. What kind of party do you want to have under a blanket? It's up to you.
A sexy party, maybe?
You could have a sexy party under a blanket. You can invite a bunch of friends or just one.
Can I invite Nicolas Cage to the sexy party?
You could invite Nicolas Cage to your blanket party.
Your I've party opened blanket. A real can of worms.
Yes, yes, indeed.
That is my pitch.
As good as party blanket sounds, party. I mean, I'm on the run.
Yeah, but that's why you need a portable party in the form of a party blanket.
I don't know.
You were
being crowdsourced milk just sounds like a bunch of diseases waiting to happen. So it's between Freedom Wheel and Kitten Wagon.
Fuck.
I like the idea. I mean, I am a runaway, and I am free.
Don't you mean it's between Crowd Milk and Wagon?
Listen.
Well, that Crowd Wheel's getting awful close to me.
I think in the end, I'm... You know, even though I'm a runaway, I don't want to be alone, and at least I'll have a kitten with the Kitten Wagon, so I'm going to give this to Kitten Wagon.
Yay! And I think
that is game.
Wow. That does it. Jen wins.
Good job, Jen. Wins.
Damn it, Jen, the Kitten Wagon.
You.
The Kitten Wagon, as soon as that came up, I was like, I fucking lost. This party
alternatively, wagon. It could also be a Pussy Wagon.
Yeah, that's what I was going to point out is, like,
oh,
one
like
more
giants.
Point. If you've ever seen the movie Kill Bill, how did Uma Thurman escape from the hospital? What was her vehicle choice?
Wagon.
It was the Pussy Wagon.
Well, if we're going by the TNN reboot, it's My Name's Book, and I like the party.
I like the party.
Yeah.
All
right. Well, real quick, why not I repost this picture of baby Nicholas or baby Ryan Gosling in chat, and then let me look at the Boru. I still have that window open, and it's incredibly critical to our needs right now.
Ew.
God.
It's kind of on the border. It's like on the line of being gross, isn't it?
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit gross. Let us see what the art is. Oh, God. There's so much furry art of me. I'm gonna,
you brought it on yourself, buddy.
I'm going to start from where the drunk stream art ended, because I think that has already been shown. I'm not sure.
yeah.
Oh my God, there's so many furries.
What's the best way for us to look at it?
You can go to this link here.
Blindsauce.buru.org.
Yeah, that specific link will give you all the things tagged under Rev. Let me bring up a screen region real quick. When's the next Tulip stream? It was... I don't know.
Oh, you're streaming Tulip? I love that game.
Yeah, I've been streaming it with Tilda for a while, but we just haven't had time to finish it. I think we've gotten farther than a lot of people.
She bought it for you, didn't she?
She did.
You a night kiss.
It's a good game. It's really weird. It wasn't what I expected it to be, but I like it a lot. I streamed that game a while ago. It's good.
It's okay if you don't finish your drawings. I will show it next stream regardless. So you don't have to worry about it. The first one is from Peacekeeper. And it is of me, Yul, or Yurable, and Vinny. This almost looks like it might be a reference to some game, but it doesn't have a game referenced, so maybe I'm just a badass with a lantern. I don't know. I'm cool with it all the same.
I'm looking at this right now.
We've got this one from Grand Dania Land Dreamer. This looks like it's probably a band thing. There's a gas mask.
Yeah, so I think that's you, Rev, Crit, and me. At least that's what it's supposed to be.
Yeah, I believe that's Crit down the bottom left.
Yeah, you, Joel. Yeah. I think they link the source of what it's parodying. I think I showed that off.
Wow, that's an image. I don't think this has anything. Rev, make it stop. What is this about? Why is...
I don't know.
What is... Why is,
I don't like it.
Why is Vinny asking me to make that stop?
Oh, yeah, I...
Mr. Zash, thank you, but I'm going to move on. This one by C of my Undertale run, spoilers. It got to this. Very good drawing. Another one by C of the Asgore fight, which went on for fucking like 5 episodes because I suck. But it is a good drawing. We've got one last one by sea of all the Algamites, because I went to the end of that as well. This area was so fucked up. It was so incredibly fucked up.
Yeah.
It was good.
I love that area, the True Lab. Yeah.
And speaking of True Lab, we've got this one of the weird thing that pets you while you're asleep. That game's kind of fucked up at that point. True Lab?
Yeah, just a little bit.
And then we've got Putus Spencer's drawing of me in a chinchilla blood fursuit.
Infinite chinchilla blood.
We have this one of Windiz of me in a fursuit. Gonna move past this. We've got one another one of Windiz as me in a Kamiguri. That's the Texan way of saying that. I make killing chinchillas sound fun. That's a quote I said. Buy a fursuit. That is also a thing. And then we've got this one by Cinepepper of the blood cup and the chinchilla fursuit. It is very cute. And there's a chinchilla there as well. It's good. I should get a chinchilla Kamiguri. It's good. It seems
more like
to be
a chinchilla fursuit.
Look.
Is a chinchilla your fursona, Rev?
No. How was Zootopia, speaking of?
Oh, I didn't actually get to see it. I was going to go see it today, but
it's
plans
a great
got
film.
Changed.
Amazing.
Yeah, I really want to see it, though. I think I'm going to go see it next week.
I have dropped so many frames this stream. Like, 58%. I don't know what's going on. But
maybe wow. Next time let me or Alex or Hootie host. Because
yeah.
You can't.
I think this game is slightly CPU intensive sometimes, maybe.
Maybe it is a little bit. It's a little bit.
What is this picture, Jim?
I can't, it's too weak.
I found it in the brew as well, and I like how Critical is like, everyone's sucking Peach's ass.
Everyone's sucking Peach's ass.
I wasn't even there, but I love that.
I think
that was
one
done by
get...
Volcanic Fires.
Is good.
Who, yeah, they made the buff stuff shirt I was selling last month. Not really good.
But I want to just thank everyone who came by, both for watching, subscribing, obviously, but also, I'm sorry, I'll make it so you can flip the table. You are the special guest, so I should let you do this.
Oh, are you talking to me? I had no idea, but if you insist, I'll flip the table.
There you go.
Ah!
And then it floats off
through this wonderful
it's
Polish street.
So fast, or so slowly, because, like, we're all lagging so badly.
Yeah.
Flip
the table.
All the same, thank you guys both for coming. Andrew, GPM, Jen, Booty.
Oh, yeah, of course.
That was a lot of fun.
That was a lot of fun. Yeah. We gotta try some of the other ones next time. We gotta get some other people as well. Just to have like a full
for sure.
Set. But maybe three, best of three next time. Thirsty. I see.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, definitely.
But
still
thank
thirsty.
You guys.
Well yeah.
Always
thirsty. It's been fun.
Thanks for inviting us. It was a lot of fun.
It was a lot of fun. And I guess I'll see you guys next time. Bye.
And before you go, what? I wanna say I'm giving you a night kiss.
I want to say bye, Stardew Valley. That's what I want to say. Do
all right, here's the plan. We get inside the Washington Monument, we set up the tickle tent, and then we give all the guards night kisses.
That's okay, that's where we're going to end the stream. Goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye.